Hi there. We are coming to you from Valley Presbyterian Church, as those of you who've been here can tell by the beautiful backdrop behind us. And we are a cello and piano duo known as a capriccio, which is capricious. We like to do what we like to do. And today's offering is a little set of, you might say, parlor pieces for a Sunday soiree. So hopefully you have your tea or treat of your choice, and you can just kick back and enjoy a little travelogue. We've just been in France playing a little piece by Gabriel Fauré called Après un rêve, After a Dream. It was published in 1879, and we're going to stick around the late 1800s, early 1900s for this program, for these sort of characterful and I want to say international stylings from the central parts of Europe mostly. Again, this was France. We're going to go actually over to the British Isles for number two. Frank Bridge wrote the second piece we'll play for you. It's called Meditation. And it was published in the first decade. They're not stating the exact date, but in the early 1900s. As it happens, Frank Bridge would be 142 this month. He's a February baby, and I think we're gonna dedicate this performance to all February babies everywhere. And the rest of you can come along too. So here's Meditation by Frank Bridge. Looking for the red light. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. We know you're out there applauding wildly, and we can feel your support and enthusiasm. Thanks so much. We are virtually alone. We have our crew of Roth and Joe, and we have Donna wrapped in a blanket because it's sub-zero. Well, no, I'm exaggerating just a bit. But we're enjoying this beautiful day inside the beautiful sanctuary. We're going to go back to France now and play a sort of lullaby set by Paul Baudelaire, a virtuoso cellist from the early 1900s. And is this the one that was published in 1934?
Yes.
How about that? Okay, so there you go, as far as, you know, sort of placing things in time. Chanson d'Alsace is the sort of lullaby, and we'll follow that with a bourrée d'Auvergne. Bourrée is a dance that started in Auvergne, France, I just learned today, because Google and Wikipedia. So, a little lullaby and a folk dance set by Paul Baudelaire. I'm confused by the lights.
Thank you.
trust you got up out of your chairs and danced to that one. It's pretty lively. That was again France. And I also learned, if you're aware of bourrées as a style, if you're experienced there, you might realize that most bourrées you hear are in a duple pattern. This was in 3D. So apparently both styles come from Auvergne, but the lower part of Auvergne is where the 3/4 time came in. But I guess the duple meter reigns from now on. So we're going to stay in 3, though, and we're going to go to Vienna after I make sure my strings are good. Fritz Kreisler was a virtuoso concert violinist, born in Vienna, traveled the world, won awards, settled in the United States, went back to Europe, went back to the United States. Besides performing as a violinist, he composed. He studied medicine because at one point in his younger years, he auditioned for the Vienna Philharmonic, and arguably the best violinist of his day didn't get accepted into the orchestra. And that's when he put down his violin and took up medicine. So for about 10 years, he was not concertizing, but he came back to it, which is good for us. And he wrote many things. This is called Liebeslied, Love's Sorrow, and it's from a set of, again, sort of parlor pieces, and it's in the style of another dance form called a Ländler, which is a precursor of the waltz. So again, in 3, and Liebeslied by Fritz Kreisler. I think the battery might be going. Thank you. Thank you. Speak louder. All right. I'm speaking louder now. We are going to leave Vienna and travel on over to Hungary, where a national dance from that country is called the Sardas, spelled a little bit surprisingly, but I won't bother with that. And this Sardas is a fairly famous one. A lot of composers took on this style. It has different sections in different tempos, and it has a lot of sort of gypsy character. This one was written by an Italian fella called Vittorio Monti. So a lot of people liked to adopt the Hungarian Sardas style. This is one of the famous ones.
Thank you.
Quick word from our sponsor.
Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Barbary Grant, and I am very blessed to be the organist here at Valley Presbyterian, and I'm kind of spearheading our Lenten concert series. So if you're enjoying this afternoon, you get five more chances to enjoy some more with a very after that, we're hosting Angela Schiace, who has played violin here for us many times in many of our choral, orchestral, major work Sundays. She'll lead the charge there, and popular classical music. The week after that, we'll be featuring Yenney, which is our young Brazilian guitarist friend, who has been providing just yummy music.
It's red.
Oh, it's red. Is this good or bad?
Hand me the other one. And
I think
on.
I'm good. Can you hear me? Sorry about that. This is our first try with the new tech. So bear with us. Thank you for your forbearance and patience. So the fifth in the concert series is an organ concert, and that will be reasonably eclectic as well. And the week after that will be Palm Sunday, and we'll be treated to a performance of the Beyoncé Mass. So please stay tuned. Sunday's at 2:30. The link that you've linked into to get to us today is reusable, and you can visit us again and again. So thank you so much for joining us today, and we're going to conclude with a Swedish piece I'll let Kris tell you about.
Thank you, Barbary. So again, we have been a capriccio, the capricious duo of Kris Yenney, that is I, on cello, and Barbary Grant on the pianoforte. And yes, we've been to France, Vienna, Hungary, England. Is that it? France again. And we're going to end with one of my all-time favorite tunes. It's been written not that long ago by Roger Taroth, who is famously one third of the Vesson Trio from Sweden. It's in a kind of a waltz tempo. It's called Josephine's Waltz. Josephine was, and probably still is, Roger's niece. And so 20-some years ago, I think, when this niece was a baby, this piece was the honorific he wrote for her. And he jokes in concerts now because this this tune has traveled worldwide and become such a favorite that it's in the bucket with a lot of traditional tunes. So the last time I heard Vesson perform this piece, Roger introduced it as this traditional tune he wrote. Anyway, it's just a lovely sort of bonbon to send you off into your afternoon, and thank you for your kind attention. Josephine.
Thank you.